Hey, I'm Pablo, and in this quick tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to set up a scene with materials for this robot character inside Adobe 3D Stager. First, open up 3D Stager and drag and drop the FBX file from the resources that I provide into the viewport. This will bring the robot mesh with all the parts that you need to get started. From the left panel, you can use the navigation tools to orbit around the model, pan the camera around, and zoom in and out. With the selection tool, you can select the folder with all the parts and use the manipulator to scale the character. Holding the Shift key allows you to scale proportionally. Now let's go ahead and set up a new camera from this button, and Stager will automatically show you the camera's frame. You can click and drag the values of the output size and change the size of the composition. Let's leave it at 2000 by 1400 pixels. You can also rename the camera by double-clicking on the name, and to get out of the render camera, click on the little circle next to the camera's name. Okay, now it's time to have fun. Let's add some materials. From the asset panel on the left, click on the second icon for materials, and you have lots of options. So be creative here. There's no right or wrong. You can experiment a little bit. From the search bar, you can go ahead and type metal just to filter the metallic materials. I'm going to choose a metal rough and drag and drop it in a part of the character that I want to make metallic. In this case, the arms, hands, and part of the feet. If you double click an object like the feet, you can see the material properties on the right panel. The material I selected allows you to change quite a few things by playing with the sliders. You can increase the resolution to 2048, select a preset like silver sandblasted metal, choose big grain as the type, and play with the sliders below to adjust the size of the grain, the intensity, and the roughness so that you can make it look shinier or more opaque. Go ahead and explore other materials and have fun applying them to different parts of the body. I'll use the metal polish for details, and this material allows you to add some scratches to the metal quite easily. Then we can use the metal brush material for the neck and the jetpack piece, and I'm gonna use the linear pattern and the nickel preset. For the shoes and the belt, you can keep it simple and add a basic metal and play with the roughness values and color to customize the look a little bit. For other pieces of the robot, we can look up rubber material and assign it to the joints and adjust some of the settings and colors as well. Let's use the rubber 2 for the hips of the robot and update the color to maybe like a dark gray and remove a bit of that sheen from the material properties. Go ahead and search for soft material and apply this yellow material to the helmet of the character. You'll notice that the base color for the material is white, although it looks actually yellow. This is because the color is given by the scattering color. So go ahead and open up the interior settings of the material and expand the subsurface scattering tab to see and change the color. I'm going to choose a light blue, but it's totally up to you. Let's go ahead and repeat the process and assign a soft plastic material to the body of the tiny robot pet. And for the little wings of this tiny robot, I'm going to keep it simple and use the default material with a dark orange color. The ring around the face of the tiny bot is also just a subsurface material with a light green color. And for some interesting look, we can use the glass material for the visor of the helmet. And this is obviously a transparent material, so we can now see the eyes of the robot. Now that we're here, let's also give the tiny bot a default material for the face with a black color and change the roughness to 0, so it is very reflective. Finally, let's go ahead and hide the visor of the robot from the scene, and let's give the eyes some glow material. We can go straight to the emission tab, change the color, and play with the intensity so we can add some light into the eyes and bring this guy to life. Now to see the real effect, go ahead and jump into the render camera, and then from the top of the interface, enable the ray tracing switch. And that's about it for this setup.